Hello, everyone. My name is Carlos Santana, and I'm the Assistant Dean for Student Affairs here in the College of Engineering and Computer Science. I would like to extend you a warm welcome and am delighted that you will be joining us this fall. The links in the webpage below will take you to more specific information relevant to your student level as an incoming freshman or transfer student. We will be providing you with access to academic advising for major and registration support throughout this summer so that you are ready to transition into Cal State Fullerton. But before you jump into advising and registration, I'd like to share information that will help you build an understanding of the support services and programs available to you. While there are endless opportunities and support services that await you at Cal State Fullerton, I will be sharing a glimpse of opportunities that support student success, specifically for students in the College of Engineering and Computer Science. The great thing about this virtual welcome is that you'll have access to this video and a PDF of the presentation conveniently posted for you. You don't need to take detailed notes, and you're welcome to return at any time to watch segments of information you are interested in. Also, the links to any of the web pages I reference will be available in the PDF version of this presentation that is posted here so that you can access that information easily. So with that, let's get started, shall we? I will be sharing a brief overview of the College of Engineering and Computer Science, including demographics, distinctions, and facilities. I'll discuss the support services available through our student success team, co-curricular opportunities that can enhance your student experience, student support programs available on campus, and I'll end with tips for you to consider as you start your educational journey at Cal State Fullerton. Before I jump into information about our college, I think you would benefit from hearing what some of our students in the Society of Women Engineers have to say about their experience at Cal State Fullerton.
Just listen to your heart. If you really like engineering, if you really like math, go after it.
When I was a high school senior, I didn't know what I wanted to be or where I wanted to go. I ended up at California State University Fullerton as a civil engineering major. As a freshman, I didn't know that many people. But then I joined SWE.
Cal State Fullerton SWE section is amazing because of many things that we get involved. So one of them is doing the pumpkin lunch. Pumpkin lunch is something very unique that just in Orange County does, and is literally launching pumpkins out of the sky, and we bring all the families together and people just come and see.
I grew to love Cal State Fullerton because it has so much to offer. The Titan Student Union is a fun place to hang out with friends, eat lunch and grab a coffee, or just study. When I'm stressed, I especially like to visit our arts building and admire the sculptures. The campus environment is just really nice to check out. For instance, we have an arboretum to stroll through, and I love being surrounded by nature and just taking a second to breathe.
We have a close partnership with quite a lot of industries in the area as well as within California. More than 99% of our students work within a 100-mile radius. So that partnership and the variety of industries that we collaborate with is extremely beneficial for our students to get the hands-on experience while they are here as students through internships, through industry-sponsored projects. So because of the richness of the support system that we provide, we do think that the students are given every single opportunity that they need to be successful, to excel, and to graduate in a timely manner. So because of all these reasons, I think students should seriously consider Cal State Fullerton and the College of Engineering and Computer Science.
Overall, I'm happy to be at Cal State Fullerton because they provide me with so much support. I'm especially thankful to my SWE family for always being there for me.
I'll share a little bit more information about the Society for Women Engineers in our student organization section. But before we get to that, I just want to talk a little bit about the degrees that are offered in the College of Engineering and Computer Science. The College of Engineering and Computer Science does offer 14 degrees through its 5 academic department areas. Not only can you complete your bachelor's degree, but you can also have the option to apply to our master's programs upon graduation. Most are offered face-to-face, but there are some online options available, such as the Environmental Engineering and Software Engineering programs. When we look at our demographics, the students in all of our programs amount to over 4,500 undergraduate and graduate students in our college. The Computer Science and Mechanical Engineering programs are the two largest programs. When we look more closely at the undergraduate student population, it is roughly composed of 3,800 students. 39% of those students are in computer science, 23% in mechanical engineering, followed by 18% in civil, 10% in computer engineering, and 9% in electrical. When we look at gender, our programs do follow the national trend where women remain largely underrepresented at a little over 15% and 85% of our student population being male. I will share more information about what our college is doing to support women a little further in the presentation because we do believe it is important to increase representation in this regard. Lastly, I'll mention that 31% of our students are first generation, meaning they are the first in their families to attend college, and that we generally have a diverse student body, as you can see, the largest being 37% Hispanic Latino students, followed by 26% Asian and 16% White Caucasian students, making up the largest ethnicity identifications. Our college has earned several distinctions along the way. Some include having our undergraduate programs ranked 38th nationally among non-PhD granting institutions and having national awards for student design project competitions each year. Our programs are nationally accredited by ABET. ABET is the Accreditation Board for Engineering and Technology. Accreditation from this organization assures confidence that a collegiate program has met standards essential to prepare graduates to enter critical STEM fields in the global workforce. So, as graduates from our ABET accredited program, you will have a solid educational foundation and are capable of leading the way in innovation, emerging technologies, and anticipating the welfare and safety needs of the public. I will briefly highlight some of our facilities. Once on campus, these are places that will provide access to technology or serve as a location to enhance your learning. Classrooms for engineering and computer science courses are designed with versatility. Whether it's a lecture, group projects, or lab work that students are engaged in may dictate the arrangement of the classroom. Some courses may begin as a lecture, and the flexibility of the classroom allows for conversion to lab work or project space during the same class time. The College of Engineering and Computer Science proudly offers spaces for students to supplement their learning with hands-on opportunities. Lab spaces are used for classes, faculty research, or student projects. Some examples include the structures or geotechnical labs in civil engineering, very large-scale integration lab in computer engineering, computer labs in computer science, or the machine shop that is used by mechanical engineering students, and sometimes by other departments as well, because we also share this space with the College of Natural Sciences and Math. The machine shop provides engineering students with a well-equipped, safe working environment in which those students can design and manufacture their projects for engineering classes, research, and vehicle and team competition through on-site technical guidance. Students using this space will be provided with training and technical guidance, as well as machine operation instruction for the purpose of providing hands-on experience, which seeks to balance and complement the strong theoretical education here at Cal State Fullerton. I'm going to switch gears now to talk about our student success team in the College of Engineering and Computer Science. The student success team in the College of Engineering and Computer Science is led by Dr. Susan Barua, the Dean of the College, Dr. Sang Jun Oh, Associate Dean of the College, and myself as the Assistant Dean. As the leadership of the student success team, we are constantly working together to ensure that support services and student success initiatives in the college are designed to meet the needs of our students. We can't accomplish this work alone, and I will introduce you to the team of advisors that you will frequently interact with in our Student Success Center shortly. Before I introduce the Success Center and the team, let me share a little bit more about my role. Students may connect with me for various things, including general questions about our college, scholarship information, and opportunities for involvement, such as student organizations. If at times you're not sure where you might need to go for support, you're welcome to start your conversation with me and we can figure it out together. One important highlight of my role is the oversight of the operations of the Student Success Center that allows me the privilege to collaborate closely with an amazing team of advisors in the center so that together we can positively impact the success of our student body. My office is located on the second floor of the Computer Science Building in CS206, and it's easily accessible and near the Student Success Center as well. Student success support systems in the College of Engineering and Computer Science are a collaborative effort that encompasses student success team, academic departments, co-curricular opportunities, student support programs, and of course, you, the student. Your dedication, commitment, and resilience as a student will play an integral role in your success. Every academic college in the CSUF campus will provide a level of support through what we call a student success team. This is a team of advisors that will be available to you as you navigate academic, personal, and professional experiences as a college student. You'll often hear the College of Engineering and Computer Science being referenced as ECS for short. Once you get on campus, you will encounter that very frequently. So I just want to point that out in case I say that during the presentation. But the ECS Student Success Center serves as a hub for overall student success. And when we have you with us on campus in the near future, you can easily find it on the second floor of the Computer Science Building in CS201. Through its services, we strive to provide a centralized area in the college where our students can access information regarding academic, career, and personal development plans. We offer academic advising, academic success workshops, tutoring, career advising, provide study space, and have a PC computer lab available for use by students. None of these services could happen without our amazing student success team, and I'd like to take a moment to introduce the friendly faces you will see when you avail yourself of this space. The first three advisors I'll introduce will be supporting the new freshman students. I'll start with Mr. Sergio Guerra, director of the K6 program and advisor for freshman students. In addition, I will share a little bit more about the K6 program down the line in the presentation, but you might hear that particular program come up throughout the presentation as well, because it's a very important component that is supported by the Student Success Center. So along with providing freshmen and sophomores with advising and programming for the K6 program, Mr. Guerra also provides supervision for our tutors in the Success Center and can share scholarship resources with students. Ms. Christina Hernandez also supports our freshmen and sophomore students with academic advising, referrals to general campus resources, and supports students that have had academic difficulties that led to academic probation. Ms. Hernandez provides advising so students can get back on track and reach their graduation goals. Mr. Roberto Montes also supports our freshman and sophomore students with academic advising, creation of study plans, and ensuring timely progress towards your degree. For our transfer students, Ms. Elizabeth Gomez will be an important point of contact. You'll interact with Ms. Gomez during the initial advising for registration, but during your academic year, juniors and seniors will typically seek academic advising within their academic departments. With that said, Ms. Gomez will assist with facilitating appeals and petitions through academic departments, will support changes to anticipated graduation dates, and provide probation advising for juniors and seniors who might need it. Finally, we have Paula Verdugo serving as the ECS career specialist that manages the career advising for all engineering and computer science students. There are two large career fairs held every academic year that the career specialist organizes for engineering and computer science students. Typically, these large events take place in the months of October and February. In addition, the career specialist creates opportunities for employers to recruit our students for internships and/or jobs through employer-specific events. Every year, engineering firms or companies like Google, Microsoft, Southern California Edison, Raytheon, among other local employers, connect with our college to host an event for students or participate in career fairs. There are a few co-curricular opportunities that students can participate in to supplement their college experience and support student success. These include scholarships and student organizations. CSUF offers both campus-wide scholarships, and our College of Engineering and Computer Science offers scholarships just for our students. In our college, we've awarded over $50,000 for 11 different scholarships. The applications are typically due in late March or early April every year. The links are included in the presentation for you to review for next year's application cycle. You'll be able to access all these links in the presentation in the PDF version provided next to this video on this webpage. The College of Engineering and Computer Science has over 30 student organizations that offer opportunities to network, develop professionally, participate in student projects, events, conferences, and offer some scholarships as well. Here is a listing of organizations by department. However, there are many others across campus that you're welcome to explore, and they offer opportunities to build fellowship through general interests, sports, faith, and other identities. Due to the technical knowledge being learned in our college, many of our student organizations offer opportunities to collaborate on projects or have study sessions, and some may even offer tutoring. Several student organizations are also participating in senior design projects. There is overlap in terms of students completing a student project, either because it's part of a senior design course, a student organization, or a project that students contribute to because of their general interest. I'd like to highlight two of the larger projects in the College of Engineering and Computer Science that are also considered legacy projects because different versions of these projects exist every year as they go compete in national competitions and student teams gather feedback to enhance the next version of upgrades. I might also add that both of these projects are interdisciplinary so that engineering students from different fields can participate in building various components of the projects. The first is the Formula SAE car, where students can learn about engineering car designs, car parts, electrical systems, and more in this very hands-on project. The second project is the Titan Rover, usually placing between 21st and 33rd in the last several University Rover Challenge competitions. It is important to note that only 35 rover teams are invited to participate in the finals that are narrowed from an initial pool of over 80 teams from over 13 countries each year. Also, this is an interdisciplinary project where students from all engineering fields have participated in the past. They've collaborated with biology majors for specimen collection protocols, business majors for fundraising, and just last year, they were recruiting computer science students to assist with programming and automation components of the rover.
For some, a car is just a car. But for others, it's more than just a piece of metal. It's a hobby, a lifestyle, a passion. The hot rodders, the racers, the drivers, the mechanics, the engineers, we all work together to create something that will change the world. We become inspired for what's to come and inspire those who can't wait for what's coming next. Every innovation, every idea we have contributes to an industry that never stops advancing. And building a race car is just one of the infinite possibilities that the automotive industry has to offer. We compete to display our accomplishments, never forgetting the hurdles and the sleepless nights we conquered along the way. We thank those who created before us, those who understand this complex art, the ones who show you the road, and all it takes is for you to take the wheel and drive. Ingenuity is what keeps us pushing for a faster, lighter, more technically advanced machine, to incorporate higher levels of discipline into what moves us, what drives us, what defines us, what fuels us.
If you're interested in learning more about either of these projects, you can follow the links here in the PDF version of this presentation. For the Titan Rover project, this video showed a time lapse of one of the first iterations of the project. You can also check out a history of the various versions of the rover over the years here in these links as well. Next, we will turn our attention to student support programs available to students in our college. The nice thing about student support programs is that they provide opportunities to expand your network of friends, mentors, and advisors. Mentors and advisors can be key in providing guidance that enhances professional skills necessary to enter the workforce. I will focus our attention on 7 specific programs. However, please note that these are only a sampling of programs available at Cal State Fullerton. You'll notice that I designated whether these programs may be more relevant to freshmen or transfer students in the slides, so feel free to refer back to this. We'll start with the K6 program first. The K6 program, for short, is the Center for Academic Support in Engineering and Computer Science that works directly in conjunction with our Student Success Center by assisting first-generation college students during their freshman and sophomore year to build community, facilitate mentoring opportunities, and increase awareness of faculty research experiences. The K6 program has been a long-standing initiative founded on the notion that support can lead to success. A few benefits of the program for active participants include academic advising, tutoring, eligibility to apply for the K6 scholarship, and priority registration for students that satisfy program requirements. Incoming freshmen that are the first in their family to go to college or graduate from a four-year university can connect with the director of the program, Mr. Sergio Guerra, to verify eligibility. Eligible students will also be invited to join prior to the start of the fall semester. The Fullerton Finish Scholars Program is offered through the Academic Advisement Center with the goal of supporting students that are seeking to graduate in 4 years. This particular program carries some benefits that include academic advising for four-year graduation, priority registration for students that satisfy program requirements, and a graduation celebration at the conclusion of the program. Incoming freshmen that are interested in this program should know that you must be able to take Math 150A or higher during your first semester at CSUF. This guarantees that you are able to progress to graduation in 4 years if you pass all of your courses. For more information, you can reach out to Joshua Loudon in the Academic Advisement Center. The Assurance program is specifically for freshmen and sophomore students in the College of Engineering and Computer Science. This program provides varying levels of financial and academic support, networking and internship opportunities, peer mentoring, and scholarships for things such as textbooks. Students from underrepresented backgrounds are highly encouraged to apply, but this program is available to all freshmen. You can reach out to Dr. Kerbakar or Dr. Wong or review the website for more information. Earlier in the presentation, I mentioned a support program specifically designed to support women in engineering and computer science. So I'd like to introduce the WISE program. Through the WISE program, women are able to build a supportive community, network up with other women in industry, faculty, or in upper class levels. In addition, this program hosts events, company site visits, has a dedicated advisor and tutor. In the past, the WISE program has been able to tour JPL, Southern California Edison, or the Disneyland backlot and meet with professionals that can provide their insights to being a successful woman in the field of engineering and computer science. If you're interested in the WISE program, please reach out to Beth Harnick Shapiro, who's an amazing instructor in the computer science department. You'll also see her be very involved with several of the computer science student organizations as well. The Lewis Stokes Alliance for Minority Participation Program offers two ways that students can participate. You can either be a program participant that makes you eligible for scholarships that can be worth up to $3,500, or you can become a research scholar that provides scholarship opportunities worth up to $5,000. All students in our college are eligible to apply. However, there are some additional criteria that you must meet, including citizenship or permanent residency, working in on your first bachelor's degree, and demonstrate social, educational, or economic barriers to careers in STEM. This program is open to either freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors. So it is there available for you. If you would like more information, please reach out to Dr. Zaire Ibragimov. You can also review the website information in the link provided, and there's also an application listed there as well. The McNair Scholars Program is designed to provide faculty mentorship, research experience, advising, and preparation for graduate school. Students must demonstrate a desire to obtain a PhD in the future to be part of this program. Additional eligibility includes maintaining a 3.0 cumulative GPA and a 3.2 major GPA, being a junior level student, and coming from a low income and first generation background. Please connect with Dr. Patricia Literte for more information about the McNair Scholars Program. Lastly, I'd like to mention the RAISE program. Some of you may already be familiar with the program if you're coming in as a transfer student, because RAISE works directly with 8 local community colleges to provide transfer student support. RAISE provides resources that support academic and career success. RAISE has a transfer resource center with a study area and hosts academic success workshops. In addition, RAISE also has a summer internship program supporting career development. You can reach out to the RAISE program directly for more information. I've reached the final portion of my time with you during this presentation. I'd like to leave you with some food for thought. The Student Success Team collaborated to compile a few success tips. We hope that these will be helpful to you as you use this summer to plan out your first semester at Cal State Fullerton. As you start to prepare for advising and registration, there are some things that will facilitate that process. For freshmen, you'll want to ensure that your AP scores are sent out to CSUF from College Board. This will ensure that credit can be applied in a timely fashion. One area where this can have an impact is your math placement, if you are planning to receive AP credit. Most freshmen will need to complete the ALEX online assessment in order to receive your appropriate math placement. Where possible, you can start with Calculus, Math 150A, you will be in a better position to graduate from your program in 4 years. You can review additional information about ALEX in the links provided. If you're counting on other credit by exam options from CLEP, AP, or IB, please review the link provided here also to give you an idea of what scores you need to have credit applied. For transfer students, please ensure that all of your final community college transcripts are requested and received by CSUF. Articulation of coursework taken at other institutions takes time, so the sooner these are received and processed, it will help with the clearing of prerequisites for your courses you may need to register for in the fall. Once you're on campus, there are some additional tips you'll want to consider so that you maximize your experience as a student at Cal State Fullerton and in our College of Engineering and Computer Science. Connect with campus resources. Whether it's one of the services in the Student Success Center, meeting your professors during office hours, or engaging with one of our several student support programs on campus, you will be more academically successful when you are connected. In addition, you will have a much easier time as you rely on the support network that you build around you. Engage with your classes. Classes are a great place to meet friends, form study groups, and meet future colleagues. Your professors are also a great resource, so if you get to know them and build a mentoring relationship, you'll also have a much easier time requesting letters of recommendation that can come in handy for graduate school, employment, or scholarship applications. Also, if you are engaged with class, you'll have a much easier time with the material that you are learning. Get involved. There are plenty of opportunities to choose from. I don't recommend taking all opportunities on at the same time, but do try different things. You can join student organizations, faculty research, or even work on campus. Working on campus brings great benefits because staff in the office you work in can also help support your work balance with your schooling in ways that sometimes is not possible with external employers. Time management will be key, and as a new student, it's going to take some time to adjust. We do know that time is finite. You have 24 hours available for each of the 7 days in a week. These weekly 168 hours are gone forever once they have passed us by, so maximizing your time and taking stock of all your responsibilities this summer will be important so that you can know where to properly invest your time once you add Cal State Fullerton classes into the mix. I laid out some basic commitments here, but the weekly time investments noted in green on the right-hand side are just estimates. You'll notice that if you add all the approximate numbers in the right-hand side, they sum up to over 168 hours available. Based on your specific commitments, you'll need to adjust the amount of time you can spend doing some of these commitments. The one area that is not very flexible will be your dedication to school because you have selected a rigorous major that is technical in nature and does require time and dedication to master. The 45 hour per week estimate needed to be in class and to study outside of class may indeed need to be higher depending on the foundational skills you already have and the aptitude to apply your problem-solving skills to the various concepts that you are learning. Lastly, creating a realistic academic plan that meets your goals by meeting with your advisor. We will be helping you with this because in our college, we require academic advising at least once per academic year. While we encourage students to consider taking 50 units per semester because it can help you earn your degree faster, we also want the pace to work for you and not against you. Earning a degree in 4 years for freshmen or 2 years for transfer students has its benefits. In the College of Engineering and Computer Science, all programs are 120 units, which makes four-year graduation possible if freshmen start off with Math 150A and pass all courses. For transfer students, it may depend on the courses completed and the credit applied at the time of transferring to CSUF that will dictate the possibility of two-year graduation from the time of transferring. In general, if you graduate sooner, that is less tuition money you would pay for schooling, and it also means that you can start your career sooner. Jobs in the engineering and computer science fields are generally well-paid positions, so for every additional year you are in school, that is an additional year of salary that you will not earn over the course of your life. You could be missing out on significant financial gains the longer you are in school. So with that, I will leave you with our contact information. Thank you very much for spending time with me today. You are welcome to connect with us anytime if you have additional questions. Once again, we look forward to having you join us in the fall and also in supporting your academic and personal successes in your journey towards obtaining your degree.